warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back to Kotkul Show by TV. I'm the first time this man like video, we can comment the video, we can join this man sharing the long room. Gabi said, one enjoy being video, nani. Join this man like a little, inshallah. I could be my best, and you didn't take the next laugh away. Begin our lazy, Rabbi was who is Ahmed Dida by Sheikh Zakinik. So you chocolate, but at Buddha Cabana, the Cavase, don't want it. I'm a guess me will be Gabana. Sheikh Ahmed Dida, if you want of Sheikh when you sort of born one of it, labor, and I get a lot of one pretty Bible and Quran, pa. But about the 1981 and 19th, the Minna San Catherine Wabble. Mandar ben be debate all the time, you know. So the body capacity, na the kind of ben will be bigger, but now who is Ahmed Dida? Wallahi, was na mumu de dunia da pa. Sheikh Zakinik India nge Ahmed Dida doke, Sheikh Ahmed Dida lord doke, South Africa nge. Imagine, you know, when be so wala namla Allah alam. The body ben kar capacity, inshallah.
Let me give you another example to compare and show the difference between goal setting. I would like to give example of the man, of the person who had very small means, but
reached
the heights in his
life. Because
the man, the person who changed my life and converted me from a doctor of a body to a doctor of soul. And I'm sure you know the name of that man. He's none other than Sheikh Ahmed Dida.
Allahu Akbar.
Let us compare his goal setting.
Sheikh
Ahmed Dida. And if you know the life history of Sheikh Ahmed Dida, he acquired education only till standard 6. Because both his ends could not meet, he was forced to leave his education. After passing standard 6, he was forced to leave his education. A man with small means. He was forced to leave the country India where he was born. Then he goes to South Africa. He does a job of a salesman. He works in a furniture shop. He does the job of driving, etc. And while he was in South Africa, he used to constantly be harassed by the Christian missionaries. Who is to tell Islam is a useless religion. It is merciless. They used to attack Islam. And because he used to get harassed, a desire came in his heart that I want to reply all the allegations against Islam made by this Christian missionaries. I want to give a fitting reply to these Christian missionaries. Imagine a man only studied to standard 6. But naturally he had faith in Allah. He strived. He stumbled across a book. You know, the books which were lying in a room which had dust on it. He stumbled across a book by the name of Izharul Haqq. The truth revealed by Maulana Karanvi, Rahmatullah Karanvi.
Benera.
And he gets the direction for his goal. That's how he started. And he strived for 40 years till the time he challenged the stalwarts of Christianity. Imagine a 6th standard pass man strive for 40 years and challenge the stalwarts of the world. So much so that in 1984, in the early 1980s, he was about to debate Reverend Jimmy Swaggart. And at that time, in 1980s, Jimmy Swaggart was the number one most powerful, most famous Christian televangelist. Just a few weeks before his debate, one of the fans of Sheikh Dida told him, Sheikh Ahmed Dida, I'm your fan, but I want to give you an advice. This man, Jimmy Swaggart, I know him. I've studied him. Please don't debate him. He will chew you and he will spit you out. Imagine a fan of Adidas giving you advice.
Lala.
You don't debate this Jimmy Swagger. You don't know him, I know him. He will chew you and he will spit you out. The person who was the most famous televangelist, who owned television channels, whose budget was more than $1 million a day to keep his head above water.
No.
Our Sheikh Ahmed Didat, mashallah. With Allah on his side, he goes to USA, in the hometown of that Christian missionary, in the country very famous. He goes and he has a debate. And
Alhamdulillah.
Summa Alhamdulillah. With Allah's help, he turns the tables over.
Like Suruk Nadeo Allah is a very sad story, man.
Imagine.
Alhamdulillah.
A man of small means. Not even past school, leave aside being a graduate. Challenges the stalwarts of Christianity. So much so that he became the biggest stumbling block for the Christianity of the world, for the Christian missionary. One man alone, Sheikh Ahmed Didat, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he challenged the whole of Christianity.
Wow.
Let's analyze his goal setting. Number one, the Islamic. Was it Islamic? Was it according to Quran and Sahih Hadith? Was it for Allah and His Rasul? But naturally it was. That's the reason he was able to achieve his goal. Number two, was it specific? Yes. His goal was specific. I want to reply to the allegations against Islam. Specific.
Islam,
I want to give a fitting reply. Remove the misconceptions about Islam that is there in the minds of the non-Muslim. Number three, was it lucrative? Was it profitable? He wanted profit in Akhira.
Inshallah.
Inshallah, inshallah. Allah will grant him Jannah, inshallah. But besides being profitable in the Akhira, it even profited him here. You know, a number 6 standard passed man, in 1986, he gets the biggest award in the Muslim world. He is awarded the King Faisal Award for service in humanity. A 6 standard man. He didn't do for the award. Maybe he got $200,000, he didn't do it for that. Maybe for the gold King Faisal Award, he didn't do it for that. He did for Allah and His Rasul. Allah profits him in Akhirah and even in this world. Lucrative. Was it apt? Was it appropriate? Very apt. At the right time. His style, everything at that time. When the Christian missionaries were hammering the Muslims, our morale was at the lowest. This man, Sheikh Ahmed Didat, he inspired thousands of youngsters, including myself. We could at least raise our head and stand. Apt. M. Was it measurable? Yes. What did he do? He collected the books of Christianity, the Christian missionaries who wrote against Islam. You know, John Gilchrist, all these books, Jimmy Swaggart, and started replying. When they attacked the Quran and Islam, he replied and he studied their scripture, Bible. Used the verse of the Quran and implemented on them and he found results. Measurable. What was his intention? His intention wasn't to become famous. His intention wasn't to win the King Faisal Award. His intention was to please Allah and His Rasul. Was he consistent? Yes, he was. Imagine, he struggled and strived for 40 years. And if you know his history, his office was a small, dingy place. And he tells us that even to print a black and white pamphlet, 1,000 quantity, they used to have a meeting. Let's have a meeting. Can we print 1,000 quantity of a black and white pamphlet? MashaAllah. Consistent. Kept on striving. Till he reached his goal.
They came Muslim, Bruni, wow. None of the Muslim, Suma Amanu Suma Kafi, Nege Muslim pure. alhamdulillah dès que musulman a poussé les coordonnées là maintenant non ou l'un des Cheikh Ahmed Dida na kera bregi Cheikh Ahmed Dida et que South Africa n'est voilà balou moi tu de gris hey télé Bible Quran et là anya bo mende school quoi et de school so va venir parce que Bible ku wele gudu tagi be beleba de time na mshika mate beleba de time ina narbala ina pastor narbala wendi bal debate baya si pastor Jimmy Swaga ele ma be debate tin tin pata chir wallahi si je kana ebe no bel mo batan kida mo zele man bem chano ba chano ba chano ba de kuno ay ko wona kulmo magadu magali sheka medita de story rose awi no fol ma bile na last year I'm like, I think during the last 2 years what I'm like, yeah. My pussy shake I made it the movie one at three made it say to be debate can Wallahi, master. Pass on my name, Mati. Huh? Wouldn't the time to shake I made it the wagon can grow. Second in lady with na. Bismillah. Wassalatu wassalam. Belebe yilna ansarwari pata itil din Islam. Be she can me do her pass preaching wallahi ngani sarare pata ba jode fe don do go bambe I had this story you know amalum posi she can me do the debate kem me the youtube expression there the kan jane de say nyen jane de bunne ga bem wallahi she can me do that wallahi bele bal never islam da ke urin de sister da na Wallahi, because one device, only advice Sheikh Dr. Zakir Naik. Wallahi, it's very emotional, you know. Wallahi, it's very emotional. See, Sheikh Zakir Naik, Dr. Zakir Naik, I'm going to know my dad, Sheikh Ahmed Dida. Wallahi. The next level, both of us, which is the Deen Islam. But, see, you know, there's a lot of work that I'm going to do. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Te won vena limbo de fora sentas venu as na nya katikana kalai kita bintin kalai pone kawli wala keci wallahi weni na ba mun pena batan kuda nya as la sidu kura so so nyele obu ma veni as se de suru yel de nya pata de ser kap sta tu sekuro atrejo nege na ro abosi se what is happiness life ni won ke desole do just ni ni ke ero anya gro nyen folie ndira ba kanyen nyen fili ba kanyen bara ya puskele ke so ma sto ma kwa ba kanyen ba de kanyen ni mulo ni ni gantele so na ida rasulullah ba kanyen no na ba de ni bawo da bu na na wallahi la sin abgen de din islam wa pe eh abgen de din islam wa pe ni de won breda wallahi la sin iba misif ga bon wallahi nombre bignas nombre music ta kana bo wallahi lazim be mo des arrangement wallahi abige ni tuna maga nyandu yendi wala dem jese mo nya kulunde mo ma daga raji kana kada chenji be biyele mo ma de manu badala ta mana badam bisbo duyendi no wallahi badam bisbo duyendo kada ga don go ne man duyendi kada lan ta mara lalum Madam McKenna, Madam Verba Nisi, Naruko to the end, so Naruto and Duyan to Mata change it. No. I don't do in the Sanya de Kutaran, but can you condone it in the Kodian didn't do this about any Kuran again? Like a Kuran was in the Lantalaga Yelly. Well, I be a little more moderna, Pata Unkuda. Well, I yelled the needed in the Din Islam the Ninuqua. And usually Nini, Cabasa Kuranada. And usually feel good, Cabasa so. And that in the Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam bada and as a life when they was not in the din islam bisnaya kabu next time then go see the corner episode insha allah so for now here guys this message give a comment and like video assalamu